exciting developments about Celebrate Your Grief that I want to share this week. And the first one is that it feels like in the past week, even maybe the past month, but definitely this past week, the energy around the subject matter of Celebrate Your Grief has really shifted. And it's really beautiful to see. It's really exciting, and it continues my own healing journey to see it happening too. And I just want to share with you that this week there was an outpouring of love and appreciation and support and just like that evidence that real life knowing came into my reality again for the person that I lost. Because it wasn't just the person, it wasn't just someone that I lost. There was the many, many lives that he touched when he was living. And so to hear those words of appreciation, and not to hear them, but to read them and to see them and to know that there's so many people that still hold him in their heart and feel the love for him, it's so beautiful to see. And it's so incredible to be part of that journey. It's really something important to me. And of course, one of the hopes that I had beginning my own journey of healing. So on that note, I've been working on Celebrate Your Grief for a number of years now, and I finished the first draft over a year ago, and now I've been going into the second draft. And part of my writing process has been to rework what was originally the last chapter, but now it's a part, and say something differently. Because when I first wrote it, I was writing also about the tool and the framework that I created called the Soul Selves. And in the Soul Selves, if any of you have taken the quiz on my website, you're familiar with the idea that was, for lack of a better word, really downloaded to me. Because when it came to me, it came so quickly and so clearly, and I wrote it and wrote the quiz and put it out there. This framework, which is a continuum essentially between your ego and your soul. And so the five soul selves that I describe on the website and on that particular blog post, they're sort of markers along that continuum. And it's a tool in the sense that it really helps us when we're on the journey to be able to identify where we are and recognize some of the experiences that we're having, some of the habits that we are having, the way that we're speaking, the way that we're feeling. And so at each one of these markers, there are sort of familiar and common denominators that I was able to tap into. And so in Celebrate Your Grief, this chapter 5 or part 5 really went back into those soul selves and described it, because it was such an important part of my own journey to be able to have these markers and to understand where I was in my own spiritual journey. And at the time, the soul selves was about the spiritual journey and the ego to the soul. And now as I go back into the second draft of the book and try and rewrite it and rework it, again, this idea of the soul selves is shining through, but from a grief perspective. And I've been able to make the correlation that there are soul selves for the grief journey as well. And I've also been able to make the correlation that there's soul selves for the self-love journey. And so the more that I think about this, it sort of dawned on me just as I was taking the dog for a walk that I am trying to write two books into one. And so now I have the inspiration and the motivation to write a proposal for a soul self book, which will be a book on its own entirely describing this framework and the continuum and the markers and the five different soul selves, and look at it from these various perspectives. Because I realize as a framework, you can really apply it to all aspects of your life. And once you understand sort of the root values in each one of the different markers, then it becomes such an easy application to all the other journeys that we have. It just includes the self-love journey and includes the grief journey and includes our financial journey and our health journey and our relationship journey and all of these other aspects that, you know, are so fundamentally important to our being and our experience on earth. So excited to share that news with you, and it helps me so much sort of resolve the hesitation I guess I've been having in terms of writing that last chapter of Celebrate Your Grief, or that last part, because again, I was trying to write two books. I was trying to put too much information into that last bit, and so now I can take that out and know that there's a purpose for that information and focus again on the story and the essence of what it means to celebrate your grief, which this week I have so much been able to do given the, you know, the experience that you know, the person that I lost is really being celebrated in other people's lives too, and it's not just me alone who is celebrating this person. So grateful to share that with you, and sending you all so much love today and every